Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. So in the last lesson, we set up our store to store the news data. In this video, we are going to set up Postgres test container to perform tests on these operations so that we can verify the operations are working as expected. I find test containers very useful because sometimes the documentation for ORM or any package that you are using to perform these TP operations is not very clear. So test containers give you a great opportunity to test these operations and verify the operations are working as expected. Before doing that, I'm going to move this Postgres setup into a different package. So let's create one. We will say Postgres and just move this file from here. I'm going to change the package name to Postgres and save it. Now let's create our test containers. So I'm going to close this. Here, I'm going to create a file store_test.go. It will be package news test. We will need to import the test container packages required for this module. The first one is test containers go. For that, we can do go get test containers, test containers dash go. Then we will need to import the test container module for Postgres. Similar thing, go get test container go slash module slash Postgres. And the last one we will need is the wait package from test containers. So let us do that as well. Go get test containers slash wait. With that, now we are ready to write our test container setup. The first function I will have here is to create a test container. So I can say func create test container. It will accept a context and return a container or pointer to Postgres test container and error if there's any. So now to make this work, we need to create an import statement. Here, let us add the Postgres test container module. So I will just say pgtc or Postgres test container, and then we can do pgtc.postgrestestcontainer. So that error is resolved. Now to perform our store test, we need to run few SQL queries like creating the database and populating it with test data to perform our test. For that, we need to read the SQL script and then run it in our test container. Working directory error os.getWorkingDirectory. If error is not is equal to nil, return container and a wrapped error with fmtrf saying working dir and then the error. We'll store these SQL script in test data directory. This means that Go will not build them into our binary. So I can just say SQL script is equal to wd plus slash test data slash SQL and store.sql. So that is the path to our SQL script. Now let us create a container. Ctr error pgtc.run. First argument is the context. Then we need to provide the image name for the Postgres that the container should use. So we are going to use Alpine image, which is a lightweight Postgres image. So version 16 Alpine, then pgtc with init scripts, providing the location for the scripts. Since this is not a new thing, we need to remove that. Now we also need to provide the Postgres database name, username and password. Let us do that. Pgtc with database Postgres. Next, pgtc with username Postgres. Similarly, pgtc with password Postgres. So we are hard coding these values so that we can connect to them when we run the test. Then the last option is test containers with wait strategy. This is required because we want our Postgres test container to be ready before we start testing it. The option we use is wait for log. The log that we use is database system is ready to accept connections. Then we need with occurrence too. So when we see this log twice, it means our database is ready to accept connections. And then with startup timeout, that is how much wait we want to have in place before we timeout. So I can say 30.time.second. Let me move it to the next line so that it's visible to us. So that's it. This will create our test container. If error is not is equal to nil, we return container, which should be nil at this point, and wrapped error, run container, and then the error. If everything works out, we return container and nil. So that should create our test container. Just to revise, what we did here was get the working directory where our SQL scripts live, and then start the Postgres test container with the scripts, providing it with database name, username, and password. Then the waiting strategy is used to make sure that the database is ready to accept connection, and then we return the container. Now from this container, we will create a new Postgres CB connection. That is what we created in Postgres. we will use this new DB function that holds the connection to the Postgres test container. So let's create that function. Function create test DB accepts a context, context.context returns bun.db. The third argument will be a cleanup function, that is to kill this test container. Let me create a type for it, DB cleanup func, which just accepts a context and returns error if there's any. So here we can just say DB cleanup func and then error if there's any. Inside the function, first thing we do is create the test container. So container error, create test container, pass on the context. If error is not nil, return nil, nil, and then wrapped error, create test container. Then to connect to the DB, let us create a mapped port. That is a mapped port to the test container. On the container, we can create mapped port. As you can see, it provides an externally mapped port for the container port that we are targeting. Provide the context, nat.port. The default port that Postgres serves on is 5432, and we want a TCP connection to it. If error is not nil, again, return nil, nil, and a wrapped error, mapped port. Next, let us create the DB from it. So DB error is equal to postgres.newDB and provide the config for it. So we can use postgres.config host. It will be localhost since we are mapping the port to our localhost. Debug for testing, we need debug to set to true. DB name, which we used here. So Postgres, then user, Postgres again, password, Postgres again, port that we set up, that is p.port, and then SSL mode, which we will disable for testing. Again, check for errors. If errors are not nil, we return nil, nil, and a wrapped error saying new DB error. Now let's create a cleanup function. So I can say cf or cleanup function is a function, is func that accepts a context, because that is what we have here. I'm creating a inline function here, returning an error. If error is equal to DB close, that is close to DB, and if we encounter any error, we return fmt errorf DB close wrapped error. If that works out, what we want to do next is terminate the container. Container terminate, provide the context, error not is equal to nil, return fmt errorf container terminate, wrap the error, and if everything works out, we return nil. Now at the end, we will just return the DB that we created, the cleanup function, and nil for error. So that's the setup for creating a test DB using test containers. First, we created a test container, then we created a mapped port to map to the Postgres port. Then we created a DB out of it, then a cleanup function to close the DB and terminate the container, and at the end, return the DB, cleanup function, and nil for error if everything works out. That's it for this lesson. In the next lesson, we will start using it to test our store functions. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!